Aha! You owe me a fiver, Luke.
Oh, great.
A fiver?
Yeah, you bet me a fiver. You'll be late for your first shift.
Cheeky.
Come on, Luke. Get your way out.
So you made it, then.
What about you, George? Did you have a little flutter as well?
Don't know what you mean, mate.
Actually, I have three alarm clocks set up at 10-minute intervals. Murder it was. Mind you, I'll get used to it. I did before.
No, you won't, mate. You never get used to it. See you on parade, yeah?
Yeah. Right, Carver. Let's do it.
Morning, everyone. Good to see you so cheerful.
Yes, welcoming the new boy, sir.
Old boy, more like.
All right, settle down. 595-340, Sierra 1. 171-521, Panda 84. 682-218, Panda 85. 944-400, beat 1. 432-600, beat 2. 248.
Looks like you've drawn the short straw, Luke.
Me?
Clean your shoes.
They'll probably put you with me to keep me on my toes.
You're joking. It's the other way around.
Right, everybody, listen up. Inspector Monroe wants a word.
Thanks, Matthew. I've had a request from CID for help with these two, Jerry and Mark Baker. Now, some of you might recognise them. They're prime suspects in a number of burglaries on restaurants and clubs. Rod Skase has been leading the investigation. I think you were involved in the case too, weren't you, Jim?
Yes, sir, that's right.
Didn't you get close to making an arrest?
Very close. Then they disappeared. They left Sun Hill.
Well, they're back. They beat up John White yesterday evening.
John White? Now, he's the guy that grassed them up, so maybe somebody grassed him up.
Could be, because White's not telling us anything now. Rod thinks that the only way that he might talk is if we pick up both Mark and Jerry for questioning. So, let's keep our eyes peeled. And if you do ID them, don't approach without backup, because Jerry has formed for ABH. OK, that's all. Thanks.
Right, everybody look at these photos before you go.
Ready when you are, Luke.
Sarge, I've got some stuff to finish first. Some case papers on a body that I nicked last night.
How long are you going to be?
Hour? Hour and a half at the most? Is that all right?
Jim?
Of course. Let me know when you're finished.
All right.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Seems confident enough.
Well, it's been a while. I hope he doesn't underestimate the change.
He wants to make it work, sir. That's why Luke's the ideal partner. Jim won't have anything to prove.
Good choice. Even so, keep an eye out, will you? Any problems, I want them dealt with as quickly as possible.
Sir.
Morning.
Hello, darling. Going our way?
Yeah.
Where's Luke?
Scarving back at the Nick.
You mean they let you out on your own? Out of shoes.
Well, did you break them in? That's probably 25 years since he last had to do that.
Yeah, thanks, Dave.
All units from Sierra Oscar, flat 55, Cockcroft Estate, a burglary. Informant to Mr. Chowdhury just returned from his night shift.
Sounds like this is one for me.
Well, steady on now, Jim. Proper policing now, you know.
Oh, yeah.
See you later.
Sierra Oscar from 682 receiving.
Go ahead, Dave.
We're not too far away from the Cockcroft. Show us dealing.
Okay.
What time did you get home, Mr. Chowdhury?
7:15. I worked the night shift at Morton's Bakeries. That's 10 to 6. I had some breakfast. I always do. And then I come home to find this.
It's all right, I'll get it.
Broken glass above the door. I knew something was wrong.
Do you have any idea who could have done it?
Yeah, I know. Jimbo?
George, I was just around the corner. Do you need a hand?
No, you're all right, mate.
Is that the point of entry?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, come and have a look at this, look.
There's some footprints here. There might be some more inside.
Yeah, well, I think we should really leave all this to the DSC. Our job's just to make the report, isn't it?
George?
Yes?
Mr. Chowdhury thinks he knows who did this. A local gang of teenagers on the estate.
600 from Sierra.
Oscar, receiving?
600 receiving, over.
Can you get down to Cheetham Road Primary School to supervise a new school crossing, please? Straight away.
Understood, Sarge. Out.
Oi! Use the crossing!
What's this? First day back and they put you on front line, yeah?
Yeah. Riot control.
Right.
600432 receiving.
Go ahead, Luke.
Done here, Jim. Where shall we meet?
Solar, you know, look for.
Excuse me. Where's the parking around here?
We can't park it here, mate. This is reserved for police vehicles only. You have to find a spot up the road, yeah?
All right, yeah, I know I should have ridden my bike. Thanks.
Got to be the new DC.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Liz Rorton met him on a drug seminar. Took an instant shine, so Kerry told me. Encouraged him to apply.
Right, you mean she fancied him?
Yeah, well, it was a weekend course in a hotel in the middle of nowhere. Mind you, I wouldn't blame her, would you?
How's it going?
Yeah, I should be all right, thanks.
All units from Sierra Oscar. The Canley Arms on Fenton Street. A burglary, the landlord attacked. Ambulance called. Can anyone attend?
Sierra Oscar from 432.
Go ahead, Luke.
Shall I steal it?
Yeah, hold on.
Shall I steal it?
Hello? Hello, it's the police.
Oh, there you are. It's just through here. Is the ambulance coming?
Yes, mate, it's on its way.
Oh, I found him.
And you are?
Chris Gunn. I was making a delivery.
Good Lord. Do you know his name?
Roger Guilfoyle.
Roger? Roger. Roger, can you hear me, Roger? That was a pulse. Sierra Oscar from 600, over.
Go ahead, Jim.
We're at the Canley Arms. Any news on the ambulance, over?
It's on way.
Thanks. Out.
What time did you find him?
Oh, about 8:45. I banged on the door. Well, it was open. When I saw him, I thought he was a goner. I mean, he's only just taken over.
Well, he's new here.
Yeah, last night was his grand opening. Big do. Well, he put an ad in the Gazette, so... But his place was packed. Then this happens.
Roger.
Luke, I'm just going to check the bar. Yes, mate?
Oh, sorry, mate. Why not wait?
That depends. Who are you?
Peter Johnson.
How do you live, Peter?
Oh, I live a few doors down Canley Road, mate. This is my local. I thought it was open.
Open?
Well, I've got this lousy hangover on. I thought, quick half, you know, air the dog and all that.
No, mate, it's closed.
Fine.
Yeah, through the back here. It's the pub landlord. We think he was attacked last night. He was found this morning at 8:45.
Okay,
who's that?
Hello.
Ah, just some idiot thought the pub was open.
You're joking.
No. Do you know something though, Luke? I think I recognise the M.O.
Let's take some gold.
Yeah.
All right, Liz. See your new boyfriend's in there in Meadows.
Very nice.
He's not my boyfriend.
He's jealous, that's his problem.
No? I thought you were getting all cosy with him at a drug seminar. You know, showing him the delights of sunny.
Yeah, what? I thought I'd forgot how to flirt working with you lot.
Liz!
Danny! How are you?
Good, great to see you again.
You too.
Of course, you two know each other, don't you?
Yeah, it was Liz first gave me the spec on Sun Hill. Made it sound irresistible.
So how did you do that?
I lied.
Well, you can do the introduction.
Right. Sir, burglary at the Canley Arms. Jim's down there now. Looks like a Baker Brothers job.
Well, you better get down there then.
Who's with you on this one?
Jim.
Well, you're going to need somebody else, aren't you?
I'll go. I mean, I don't know, maybe the introductions can wait. I mean, I'd rather be out and about if that's okay with you.
Sure, why not?
Danny Glaze.
Yeah, hello.
Pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
So what's the score with these guys?
Ross.
Jim. All right. Oh, this is DC Danny Glaze.
Pleased to meet you.
Hello, mate. Yeah.
I brought him up to speed on everything. I told him that you and I were working on this.
Okay. Now, this is the Baker brothers. I'm sure of it. And some. Over here. Now, it all took place after a party which had been advertised like the others. Now, Mark or Jerry could have easily have slipped in here and waited and let the other through the open window. Except this time they were disturbed by the public and Mr. Guilfoyle, and things turned nasty.
So they did, didn't it?
They'd been violent before?
No, just threats. They'd been careful.
Yeah, with Jerry's record, it's just a matter of time.
Oh, Jim. It's all right, mate. We'll take over from here.
Oh, he's just down the back of the road.
So you found him, yeah? Was he uncle?
Sorted.
Yeah, thanks.
All units from Sierra Oscar. Traffic accidents at Shipley Street. Can anyone deal?
That's just up the road from here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sierra Oscar from 600 receiving, over. Here we go.
This idiot's just driven into the back of me and he's got no insurance.
And your name, sir?
Stan Barnes.
And you?
Brian Wood.
And you were the driver of the van at the time of the accident?
Yes.
How about you?
Marvin Eakin.
Are you the owner?
Yeah. And the van belongs to me, okay.
Right, we're going to have to fill in an accident report. Luke. Luke, it's Mark Baker!
Sure, it was Mark Baker.
Absolutely positive.
As soon as he sees us, he legs it.
I'm sorry, mate. Look, he got away. That's what
right.
Can I say?
All right, don't worry about it. Look, Jim, it's nobody's fault. I mean, if you were throwing a blinder, what else could you do?
Luke.
Jim.
Come on.
It's all right. We've still got the rest of the investigation. There's still plenty to play for. Jim! It's for you, Rod.
It's the news. Mr. Guilfoyle has regained consciousness, wants to talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll get that. No, I don't want it, thanks.
No? Give me 10 minutes. There's something I want to do first.
All right, but where will you be?
I'll find you.
How's it going?
Fine, Sarge. So how did you lose Mark Baker?
Oh, you heard about that then?
Well, there were two of you.
It was just one of those things, Sarge. It couldn't be helped.
You're set?
Yeah.
Go on, then.
Thanks, Sarge.
Do you remember the bloke who turned up at the Canley Arms, said he wanted to drink, told me his name was Peter Johnson?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, when I thought about it, it all seemed a bit dodgy. So, I went into the DIU and I made a positive ID. Peter Johnson has got a string of convictions. He's also a mate of John White.
The guy who grassed up the Baker brothers?
Yeah. Now, Johnson told me he lived in the Canley Road, but not according to his file. So what was he doing at the pub? I've got his address. Why don't we go and find out?
Jim, shouldn't we give this to CID?
It's worth a try, isn't it, surely?
Well, what about our beat?
Just one visit, one conversation. I really want Mark Baker, Luke. It's personal. It's unfinished business. All right. Mr. Johnson, can we have a word? We met earlier today at the Canley Arms.
What about it?
You said it was your local, Mr. Johnson, but you don't live anywhere near it, do you? So, what were you doing there?
Fancied the walk.
I don't believe you, Mr. Johnson.
Believe what you like, mate. It's a free world. Now, excuse me.
If you get in that car, Mr. Johnson, and attempt to drive it away, you will be committing an offence.
What?
Your tax disc is out of date.
Yeah, well, it's in a post.
What, for 6 weeks? Would you mind checking your brake lights for me, Mr. Johnson? Well, while we're at it, we'll have a good look at your tyres, front and rear.
What are you giving me grief for? I ain't done it.
You went to the Canley Arms this morning, and I want to know why.
Jim, we could take that.
Yeah, look, someone else might attend. Do you know John White, Mr. Johnson?
No.
What about the Baker brothers, Mark and Jerry?
Who?
Jim, we're just round the corner.
Yeah, just wait.
No, we can't. We've got to respond, all right? Sierra Oscar from 432 receiving.
Luke.
Sarah's dealing.
You've been stunned here. No, my physics,
eh? Yeah. It's a shame we didn't get a good look at his attackers, though. It was Mark and Jerry, all right, and I bet it was Jerry who had to be pulled off.
So what do we do now?
Go see Mr. White. Apply some pressure.
You think White will talk?
He will when I finish with him.
No, this guy was burgled early today, so this might have something to do with it.
You can't keep him here.
Excuse me.
Excuse me. Would you move away from the door, please?
He's locked our mate in the cupboard. He's left him in the cupboard.
One at a time, please. What's happening?
He's locked our mate in the cupboard. He dragged him out. He threw him into the cupboard.
Would you let us handle this, please? Mr. Chowdhury, this PC Carver, Sunhill. Will you open up, please?
All right, Matt.
Let him out.
Oi, Matt! You're coming!
Let me handle this. All right.
Thank you.
All right, son, we'll get you out there as soon as we can. Mr. Chowdhury, what is going on?
He's responsible for all this. They've been trying to knock my door down for half an hour.
Okay.
But what am I supposed to do, lie down and take it?
You've proved your point. Now open it.
No.
You're not helping yourself here.
Jim, maybe we should call for backup.
Mr. Chowdhury is just about to give me the key, aren't you, Mr. Chowdhury?
It could get nasty.
Luke, I said I would handle it. Mr. Chowdhury, I do not want to have to arrest you. Now give me the key.
Thank you. What's up?
Come on, that's it!
You are direct. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something which you later align in court. Do you understand?
Yes!
So they jump away. The cameraman is one of the first to show. He run to the first flight of hurdles.
You got visitors.
He's also well there. All of them safely over. The back marker is Jack.
Mr. Skase from Sun Hill. Oh, sorry, what did you say your name was?
DC Glaze.
I see. Bought me some flowers, have you? Trying to keep me sweet.
Dad.
What do you think they're here for?
Actually, John, we've come to see how you are.
As if you care. Well, I'm still in agony. Okay.
Come on, Dad, you're on the mend. I'm just staying a few days to help look after him.
Is that what you call it?
Yeah, tender, loving care. Or can I get you a cup or something?
They're not staying.
Dad, will you just listen to what he has to say? Go on.
Thanks. John, we've just come from St. Hugh's, where we've been talking to the new landlord of the Canley Arms, Mr. Guilfoyle. Well, he had a huge opening party last night. You know, lots of people and that. And as they were leaving, he was doing his cashing up and he heard this noise in the gents. Well, I can guess you can imagine what happened next, can't you?
Jerry and Mark again, yes.
Yeah, that's right. Totally unprovoked, you know, he didn't stand a chance. He's in intensive care now.
Will he be all right?
Well, he'll live.
It's Jerry who did it. He's the vicious one.
And was it Jerry who did this to you? John. You listen to me. First it was you, then Mr. Guilfoyle, then what?
You're not having a statement.
Why not?
Look at me!
I guarantee your safety if you tell us where they are.
I don't know where they are.
You must know something!
No, I don't.
Come on, don't muck about. Tell him what you know.
I can't. I'm sorry, I can't, and that's it.
Sarge.
What
have you got here? It's Luke's body, Sarge.
Luke.
I arrested Mr. Chowdhury for assault, Sarge.
I don't believe this. I've already apologised to them.
It's too late for that now, sir.
Right. Better get on with it, then.
Look, don't be too hard on him. He's still really scared.
That's exactly what Mark and Jerry want, Ella.
But I've never seen him like this.
Then get used to it.
All right. I'll help you. It's not a lot, but...
Go on.
There's this house on Lasswade Street. A number one. Dad part owns it. He gave the Baker brothers a key a while back. You could try there.
Thanks.
This is ridiculous. I have to tell you what happened all over again.
For the tape, please, Mr. Chowdhury.
Well, I hit you. It was a very stupid thing to do. I don't go looking for trouble. I get on with everyone. I was just angry, that's all. Look, I've said sorry. What else can I say? Isn't that enough for you?
I think that's more than enough, Mr. Chowdhury.
Right, Mr. Chowdhury, this way.
So, what are you going to do, Luke? You going to charge him?
He did it, Jim.
He overreacted, Luke, and he wasn't the only one. Now, be honest, there's no need for all of this. It could have been handled a lot better.
You mean so you could have got back to Johnson, right?
All right, what do you want me to do with him?
We were just discussing that, Sarge, weren't we, Luke?
Yes.
You want him charged?
Well, I think a caution would be more appropriate.
Well, Luke, it's your body.
I agree with Jim, Sarge.
So you want to drop the assault?
Yes, Sarge.
Right, so I'll tell Mr. Monroe, then he can caution him and we'll let Mr. Chowdhury go.
Thank you.
Hey, Jim. Jim, hang on. How are you getting on out there?
Like a duck to water, Sarge. It's like I've never been away.
How are you finding working with Luke?
Fine.
Teaching him everything you know?
Something like that.
Hi, Jerry.
Oi!
Tom, do the upstairs, will you?
Just be... Ah.
All right, look here!
Just calm down.
Watch my arm!
Shut up. Come on.
No sign of Mark.
Oh, look, it's Jerry Baker. Well done, Rod. Any sign of Mark?
We're working on it.
Shouldn't we tell them about Peter Johnson?
Tell them what?
We don't know anything yet.
But aren't we withholding the information?
All units from Sierra Oscar. A gang of teenage shoplifters have been sighted at the Canley shopping centre. Anyone free to patrol the area?
We can do that. Sierra Oscar from 600, over.
Go ahead, Jim.
Can you show us attending? Canley shopping centre just round the corner from Johnson's house. Come on.
Not as good as his old man, though.
I've got a mate at the Villa Fire told me that.
Rod, just have the DSE on the phone. She's got a set of fingerprints from the gents' window of the Canley Arms.
Oh, yeah? Nice one.
Said she also found a bloodstained cap behind a waste paper basket.
The baseball cap?
That's right.
It's a black man sugar. Guildfall's attackers are wearing baseball caps.
They're a slogan over the peak, the fabulous Baker brothers.
Not anymore, they're not.
Right. I'm off to see Johnson. He's only a few minutes away.
Jim, look, we've been here for half an hour and we haven't seen anything. If you need me, radio me. I'll be straight back, I promise.
Could you tell me what you were doing last night, Jerry?
This and that.
Be more precise.
This and that and a bit of the other.
What about your brother? What was he doing?
Same as me, fancy free.
So you were together then?
We're brothers. We hang out.
Where did you go?
Round and about.
And this round and about, did it include the Canley Arms?
Never heard of it.
See, last night there was a party there. A great deal of money was spent. Afterwards, the landlord was beaten up in the gents' toilets by two men and robbed.
Oh, tut tut. They won't be invited again.
They won't be going anywhere again, because they were careless. Forensics having a field day, they've got fingerprints, bloodstains, the works. I'm now showing the suspect exhibit TU1, a white baseball cap that was found in the gents' toilets. Do you recognise it?
No.
Right. What about the slogan on the front? The fabulous Baker Brothers.
It's not mine.
Okay, well, don't worry. We found a hair on the cap. We can do a DNA check. We can also do that for bloodstains, too. My guess is that they match the landlord. The thing is, Jerry, the landlord told us that one of these boys went mental. You know, he really lost it. Was that you? Did you start hitting him? Couldn't stop? Did Mark have to pull you off?
Are you finished or what?
Is it good news or bad? Will Pete thank me for telling you?
Do you know where he is, sir?
Try the betting shop in Elvis Road. He's always there lunchtime.
Thanks!
Mr. Johnson!
Yeah,
excuse me, Mr. Johnson. Could you please show me what you're doing down at Canley Arms this morning?
Look, I already told you, mate. I don't know nothing.
No?
All right?
What were you doing at the Canley Arms this morning?
All right. Well, if I tell you, will you keep me out of this?
I was the only one who saw you, remember? Look, no one else knows about this.
I was rung up 8:30. Jerry told me to get down to Canley Arms and fetch some baseball cap he'd left in the toilet. Both he and Mark were lying low. Look, I wanted to say no, but you can't exactly say no to Jerry Baker, can you now?
Well, you can now. He's under arrest.
What, Jerry?
Which only leaves Mark. So, one last question, Mr. Johnson. Where can I find Mark?
I assistance requested. Canley Shopping Centre. Group of teenage girls. I see one. I see two.
Luke, look, I'm sorry, mate. I got held up with Johnson. But I've got to live with Mark Baker, though.
Didn't you hear me?
Luke.
I called for help, Jim. Didn't you hear me?
Yes, I heard you, but I thought you could manage by yourself.
Oh, you did you? And why is that? Because I'm some Mickey Mouse copper and you ain't?
600 432 from Sierra Oscar receiving. 600 and 432 from Sierra Oscar.
Go ahead, Sarge.
Jim, I'd like to see both you and Luke in my office, please. Immediately.
Received. Out.
Jim.
I'm running CAD today. I'm listening to everything. Sergeant Boyden calls you back in. Now, what's happening?
Jim, he's called you back in.
I let someone escape this morning. I was following a lead. Well, I should have been somewhere else. I compromised my fellow officer. I left him in the lurch, Sergeant.
Jim, this isn't about being wrong. You're not wrong. You can be right. I've been right, and I've pursued that rightness. But you know, I know, you have to understand when to stop. And it's difficult.
I think really, Sarge, it's just a different way of working.
One of the deep, deep lessons of being in this uniform, of being in this blue, is that we're together, that we are not alone, that we are supporting each other.
I don't know if I can do it.
I know you'll do it.
Where were you?
Nearby.
What were you doing? Something came up. Something more important than patrolling the shopping centre, as you were instructed?
Well, I was,
Well?
It was his shoes, Sarge.
Shoes?
Yeah, see, they were new today and they were giving him blisters, so he went to put some plasters on. Well, he came back as quick as he could.
I bet he did. And what about the arrest on Mr. Chowdhury?
Sarge?
Sergeant Ackland said there was a disagreement over it. Was there?
No, Sarge. See, I wanted to charge him, but then me and Jim had a discussion, and I realised that a caution would be more appropriate.
So there was a disagreement?
Well, nothing serious, Sarge, was there, Jim?
No.
It was a mutual decision.
So everything's fine? No trouble at all?
Fine, Sarge, yeah.
No, nothing.
Go on then, get on with it. Thanks.
Listen, whatever problems we have, we sort out between ourselves, all right?
Danny!
You're not going to be happy until we get him, are you? Why? It's not your responsibility anymore, Jim.
Excuse. Danny,
How'd you get on with Jerry Baker?
Well, needless to say, we didn't get her anything useful, but we're going back to see White's daughter again. So, don't hold your breath.
You want this result, don't you? Got just over an hour before our shift ends.
You want to go after Mark Baker?
Well, why not? The worst thing is, we draw a blank and we give whatever we know to Rod. No arm done. No other hand, no.
Good lad.
What happened? Did you get them?
Well, we went to the house, we found Jerry, we arrested him. But no Mark.
Who is it?
It's all right, Dad, it's for me. So, why have you come back?
Because your old man knows where he is and he's going to tell me.
All right, let me do it. Talk to him.
No, I'm going to talk to him myself.
But don't you get it? He sees you, he gets scared, he clams up. If I'm his daughter, he might listen to me in private. Come on, I put myself on the line for you. Give me a chance.
All right. But you better make damn sure that he realises the attack on Guilfoyle has changed everything. And he's not going to sit on the fence much longer while I'm busting myself. Do you understand?
OK, let's see if Mark Baker's inside then.
We can't just walk in, Jim.
OK, you watch the front.
I didn't see Mark Baker, but I did find something else. Come on.
Excuse me, are you the landlord?
Yes, me, it's my guy.
Well, I wonder if you could help us. We're looking for a young man called Mark Baker.
Who?
He's about 25, 5'9", he's got ginger hair.
Sorry, could be half my regulars.
Well, you don't mind if we have a quick look around, do you?
But you won't find him.
Oh, so you do know him?
No, I don't.
Oh, but you do. You see, we've received information that he comes here quite often. He likes to gamble here.
Gamble? No one gambles here. I'll run a straight pub.
Really? So what about the equipment through here?
Yeah, well, it was a charity night.
Oh, what's my name? Lassie.
Tell me about Mark Baker.
Look, if I do, you won't report me.
Let's say I would reconsider.
Yeah. All right, look. He was here last night. I mean, flush he was. Bag full of cash, flashing it about. He played the wheel, some cards. I wanted to close up, but he kept on going. Mouthy, too, full of himself. All night long, and I couldn't get rid of him.
So what time did he leave?
About 9 o'clock this morning. His driver took him home.
Driver?
Yeah, Mark lost his licence. So he hires somebody from the local minicab firm. Sit outside all night long, pays over the odds.
But his name's Brian Wood.
Why don't we go back and question Jerry again?
What are you talking about? Got nothing last time.
There was one moment when you mentioned the attack on Guilfoyle, the violence. Jerry totally lost his cool when you blamed him, remember? Well, I think that's because he didn't do it. Guilfoyle says his attacker was out of control, yeah? But what we know about Jerry's form suggests that he uses violence for a purpose. He's not indiscriminate. So, what if it was Mark who lost it, for some reason? And not Jerry at all?
Hey, go on, I'm listening.
So, if we question Jerry again, along those lines,
yeah, all right.
Rod, do you mind if I lead the interview? Fresh face, different approach. I know what this is all about, Jerry. It's about you being a good brother. You see, up to now, everything has gone great, yeah? The burglaries were well planned and carried out. You scared people, but you never got with the real deal. Nobody was hurt. Until last night. Something definitely went wrong. I know the attack on Guilfoyle wasn't meant to happen. All that violence must have thrown you. Made you careless.
You left your baseball cap behind, other evidence. I mean,
the whole thing was totally unprofessional. And you are, if nothing else, a professional, yeah? But deep down, you know that forensics is going to send you down for this, Jerry. Don't you? Because it will. But you're still loyal to Mark, obviously. And believe me, I admire that. You still want to look after him.
I won't tell you about it, yes.
Okay, no, don't. But it was Mark who attacked Guilfoyle, wasn't it? Jerry. You know he's a nutter. So you're happy just to sit in here while he's out walking the streets, yeah? Are you really prepared to let that happen? Jerry, listen to me. Give it up. Look. It doesn't make you a bad brother if you get help from him. Because you know he needs help. So, was it Mark who attacked Guilfoyle? No, say it, Jerry, for the tape.
Yes, he hit him.
Why?
Because he was seeing this girl. He really liked her. I mean, Mark, serious about a girl, he must be joking. Then a couple of days ago, guess what? She gives him the push. He was fuming. He was done in. I mean, he was just like this bomb waiting to go off. And, your man Guilfoyle was in the wrong place at the wrong time. He copped it.
So why did you give him the push?
Because her dad was doing a few jobs for us, that's why. She didn't like that. She says we were making his life hell.
Are we talking about John White, Jerry? Was Mark going out with Ella?
Yeah.
Here we go.
I'm sorry, Mr. Woods.
Did we wake you up?
Yeah. Do you mind if we ask you a few questions?
No.
Should have told us right from the start.
I tried to help you, didn't I?
No. You tried to cover for yourself and play for time.
Well, what else was I supposed to do after what Jerry and Mark did to Dad? If he'd have known, he'd have never forgiven me.
Too right.
So, thanks for nothing, fellas. You've really helped.
When did you and Mark split up?
A couple of days ago.
How did he take it?
Well, badly. He was so used to getting what he wanted, he couldn't believe it. He never thought I'd be the one to finish it.
So that's why you've been so nice to me these past few days?
No!
You two-faced bitch!
Right. Take it, just take it.
Come on, John. Tell us where we can find him. Come on.
Tell him what you know, Dad!
Get out! Get out!
Yeah, receiving you, Jim.
I've got some good news for you. If you're still looking for Mark Baker, I think I've found where he's hiding out. Over.
Oh, great. Where's that, Jim?
Well, you know those lockups on Jessop's Lane? Over.
Yeah, I know them.
Well, I'll meet you there in 10 minutes. Oh, and bring someone with you, yeah? Over.
Gotcha. Will do. Out.
Right.
This way, gentlemen.
Mark Baker, open up, it's the police!
Cuff him.
Well done, Mark.
That's
very good.
Alan Hansen says
what are you talking about, Alan?
Midfield play.
He looks in the singing of praise, isn't he? If I'm not, Simon.
Yeah, well, it was teamwork.
It took the uniform to get the brain working, did it?
So, look, can you come join us for a swift one?
Yeah, I've just got some paperwork to finish.
Oh, blimey. Don't be 12 and a half years this time.
Hey, me and Danny are going for lunch. Do you want to come?
No, thanks, Liz. I wouldn't want to get in the way.
No, you're not getting in the way. I won't even notice you're there. Hey, Jim. How's it going?
I got a result. Mark Baker. Not bad for a first day, eh?
Yeah, good. Danny Glaze. Jim Carver.
Yeah, we've kind of met. How you doing?
The new DC. Well, I'm the old DC, now the new PC.
Liz told me all about you. She had a lot of respect for what you did.
And like I had no choice, right?
I'm over here. See you.
I'll see you later. Even so, I mean, back in uniform at the same nick?
Better the devil you know.
Oh, trust me, I couldn't do it.
It does feel strange.
I'm sure it'll work out, though, yeah?
I'm sure it will.
I'll see you later.
Come on,
Dad. Oh,
this is your room.
Oh,
pretty nice.
So
nice.
Yeah, see you tomorrow. End of the first shift, then? Yes, Sarge. I'm just off for a drink to celebrate. Feel part of the team now?
Yeah, I do.
Good. So whatever stunt you pulled earlier, you won't try again?
Stunt, Sarge?
Listen, you got away with it. That's fine. But you're supposed to be an experienced officer setting a good example. Make sure you do, Jim. Because I'm going to be watching you. All right?
This is not a holiday. It is about pressure.
I can't go any higher, Jack! No way!
On the body, the mind, and the team.
It's time to grind.
Yes.
You're supposed to do what's good for the team, not for yourself.
Hey, you leave me out of this.
Don't sit on the fence. Go on, you tell him what you think.
I would hate to work under an operator like you.
Well, the truth is, I'm sick of you two squabbling, and I'm off.
I'm riding along on the crest of a wave.
Oh, and you can keep your mouth shut, Derek. The rope's jacked.